Hey, what's up YouTube? Hope you're all doing well. Today I have a tutorial on designing a business card. I'm going to run through how you set up your document firstly in Photoshop, and then how to design the artwork in Photoshop for your business card. From there, I will show you how to set up your print-ready document in InDesign, and how to export the business card and the artwork from Photoshop to InDesign, ready for print. The first thing you will need to establish with your client, or if this is your business card, establish with yourself, are the dimensions. I have put a link in the description below of various dimensions used in the industry around the world. Some are portrait and some are landscape. I personally prefer to use portrait designs, as you can see here for my most recent business card design. Here's a design, pre-print and then again afterwards. You can see I've changed it slightly, but I'm really proud of how this came out, and this is a design for myself. However, the most generic and most common dimensions used that I've encountered when designing a business card is 85mm by 55mm landscape. Once you have the dimensions established, you need to set up your document in Photoshop. You must understand that in the printing industry and the design industry, there is something known as a bleed. A bleed is a term that is used to describe a document which has images or elements that touch the edge of the page, extending beyond the trim edge and leaving no white margin. When a document has a bleed, it must be printed on a larger sheet of paper and then trimmed down. Adding a bleed is professional and helps the printer cut down your design effectively. I and many other designers use 3mm bleed around the entire design for business cards. So let's set up your document in Photoshop first. Here is a quick tip or hack for you guys. Go to new document and put in the dimensions, so 85mm by 55mm. And you want to use 300 ppi, which will give the best quality for something this size. This right now has no bleed. So drag 4 guides down to each edge of the canvas. Then go up to Image, Canvas Size, and add 6mm to both measurements. You add 6 and not 3 because you want 3mm around the entire canvas. There will be 6mm in total in height and width, if that makes sense. So the document will be 91mm by 61mm in total, which would include the 3mm bleed around the entire design. From here, you can go and design your artwork, remembering that anything outside of these guides will be cut out and thrown away in the printing process. So keep your most important information, such as contact info, etc., within these margins. The artwork side of this is going to be completely up to you, of course, and your design spec. Just remember that anything outside of these margins will be cut away and discarded. I have here a design I did back in 2015 for a fashion label. I had to design the logo and the business cards as part of the full branding project. I'm going to use this for the purposes of this video. But once you have your artwork, you will need to save the JPEG, but it's best to flatten this beforehand. So go to Layer, Flatten Image. Now open up InDesign and create a new document. Make sure Print is selected and then click 2 pages. You will want to use the measurements we did back in Photoshop, so 85mm by 55mm. and then click 3mm for the bleed and select this icon right here to spread it across the entire canvas. You can preview your canvas by clicking here, or just go ahead and generate it, and you should have something that looks like this. Go ahead and select the box tool here and create a new box over the entire page, including your bleed. Once you've done that, select the white arrow tool here and highlight the box. Head over to File and then Place. Find your image and click it. It should fit perfectly if you've used the right measurements. If the quality looks bad like this, it's most likely because the view mode on your desktop is not set to high quality. To change that, go to View, Screen Display Performance, and then High Quality. Now repeat this for the other side, and your business card is almost print ready. Make sure to save your document before you go and export, but once you have saved it, go to File, Export. You will want to select Adobe PDF for print. Make sure to select the most recent version of Acrobat Reader. For the layout, when printing business cards, I like to choose 2-up continuous facing. On compression, you should have these values. Marks and bleeds, select Printer marks, all printer marks. And for the output, no color conversion. After that, hit export and you will have it finished. You can check the quality of your work in Acrobat Reader. You can check for any anomalies or any issues that have arisen. And of course, your client can check it too. Your business card is now print ready. I want to hear your comments and your thoughts, not only on this video, but for future videos, so don't be shy. Make sure to subscribe for future content. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.